Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to use the face recognition library to detect and recognize faces and images. So this library is very popular and it's one of the easiest ways to recognize faces. But the problem is that this requires a GPU to work efficiently since it uses many deep learning models to recognize the faces. And also it is based on the library called dlib. And setting up dlib on your computer is time consuming. So the solution here is to use Google Colab. And Colab comes pre-installed with dlib. And to install the face recognition library, all you have to do is pip install it like this. So before we execute this, let's change our hardware accelerator for this notebook to a GPU so that face recognition can run smoothly. So to do that, go to edit and go to notebook settings, and inside hardware accelerator select GPU and save. Now this will connect to an instance that has a GPU in it. Okay, once it's connected, we can run this. So this installed. So before we start coding, let me explain quickly how the face recognition library works. So on a very high level, what it basically does is that for each image or each face, it generates 128 measurements, and these 128 numbers basically correspond to an encoding for this particular face. So for every single face, these numbers would be different. So a deep learning model is trained so that it takes a face image as an input and generates these 128 numbers as output. So the great thing about this model is that faces that look similar will have similar encodings, and for the faces which are different, they will have very different encodings. So let's say, for example, you have a project where you have a list of known people or known faces, and then you have a set of images in which you want to check if any of these known faces exist or not. Okay, let's call them unknown images or unknown faces. So what we do first is that we generate this encoding for all the known faces. So to check if any of these known faces are there in new images, we generate the encoding of the new face or the new image and compare it against the known encodings that we had calculated earlier. And to do this comparison, any type of a distance measurement or a classifier can be used. So basically the same faces or the faces that look the same will have a very small distance between them, and the faces that look different will have larger distances between them. In this way, we can recognize a known face from a set of unknown faces. So if you're interested to know more and how this exactly works, you can check out this post on Towards Data Science. I'll link this in the description. So this post is actually written by the author of this face recognition library. So on the GitHub repository for this library, you can go into examples and find many more examples that you can check out and use. So the intention with this video is just to get you started, and you can start using this library in your personal projects easily. So now let's start writing code. So before that, we need to download a few known and unknown faces. So what I'm doing here is that I'm creating two directories called known and unknown, and these are some random images that I found on Google of Elon Musk, Bill Gates and Obama. And I also have images of the same people and one extra image, and I've named it as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Using these known faces, and we'll be checking if any of these faces are present in this set of unknown faces. So let's execute this. Okay, once it is downloaded, you'll see that there are two directories that are created, known and unknown, and you can take a look at these images. So next, let's start writing code. So here I have imported all the libraries that we'll be using today. Now, before we start, let me write a function called readImage, which will be used to read our images and resize them, because if you notice, some of these images are like really big and we don't need such huge images for our purpose. So we'll be resizing them. So what I'm doing here is that I'm first of all reading the image into this variable, then I get its height and width, and then I'm setting a constant value for width to 500 pixels. So basically, No matter what size the images, I want its width to always be 500 pixels. I'm finding out the ratio, which tells me how much this image has been scaled down, and I'm using that factor and applying it to the original height to get my new height. Then I use cv2.resize to resize the image. Next, let's declare a few variables. So known encodings is a list that will be used to store the encodings for all our known images, and known names will be used to store the file names for these known images. So we will use this later on to display these names, and in this variable I'm putting the directory name where all my known images exist. Next, what we'll do is that we will iterate through each image in the known directory and we will generate encodings for them. So for each file, I'm first of all going to read the image using the read image function that I wrote earlier. Okay, this creates the path to every image. Now let's generate its encoding. So image enc. So face recognition library has this function called face encodings that generates the encoding for all the faces in a given image. So let's say if my image has three faces, then this function is going to return a list that consists of three sets of encodings, each corresponding to each face in the image. Okay, so since we just have a single face in all these images, I'm going to index this to 0. The output of this will be a list with a single element, so I'm storing that element, which is the encoding, in this variable. And if you are dealing with multiple faces, then you can consider this as a list. Now let's add this encoding to our known encodings list, and let's add this file name to our known names list. So I'm splitting this file name by the dot because I don't want this .jpg to come when I display this later. So I just want the name part of this. Okay, let's see what's inside the known encodings variable. Okay, so you can see that the encodings generated for all these faces are in here. So now we are ready to generate the unknown encodings and do the comparison. So just like we did here, we are doing the same steps for unknown faces as well. So I've declared this unknown directory, and for each file in my unknown directory, I will read the image and I will generate the face encoding for that particular image. Okay, and we are taking only the first element because we just have a single face in our images. And I'm also printing out the file name that is currently being processed so that we know which out of these is being processed right now. Okay, so now we are ready to compare the encoding of this unknown face against all the known encodings. So face recognition has this method called compare faces that takes in the list of all the known encodings and compares each one with the unknown encoding, and it returns a Boolean array which is true if this unknown encoding matches any of these known encodings. Okay, so let's run this. So you can see that for the second image, all three are false, so it did not match any of these three. So let's see why that happened. And that's because the second is my image and it does not look like any of these, right? So this method compare faces basically gives you a true if it matches any of the known images or known encodings, and it returns false if it does not match. Okay, you can see that in the other images, one of these indexes have been set to true, which means that a match has been found. So to know whose image that is, we are going to use the known names array. So we are going to print out the particular name where the index is set to true. Okay. Okay, so iterating through each result, if it is true, if the value of the result is true at any point, then print the same index in known names. Okay, so it's processed one and it's printing Elon. So let's check if one is an image of Elon Musk, and yes, it is. Similarly, let's see, four is an image of Obama. Let's check that, and that's also right. And three would then obviously be Bill Gates. Okay, so instead of this compare faces method, there is also another method in this face recognition library, and this method is called face distances, and it gives you the actual distance between each of these faces. So basically, what this compare faces method does is that if the distance is less than a particular threshold, then it returns true or it returns false. So you can see here that all distances are quite high here, whereas here the least distance is 0.49. okay, so this would be set to true in this case, and here 0.34 would be set to true, and here 0.49 would be set to true. So you can use this method and check which encoding has the minimum value and say that okay, this face is actually similar to that. Or you can use this compare faces method, which should be enough for most cases. So next, what we'll do is that we'll use OpenCV to actually draw on top of the unknown face and mark whose face it is. Okay, so I'm going to say instead of known names, I'm going to call this name. So I have the person's name. Now all I have to do is to draw on top of the new image and write the name. So what I'm doing here is that face recognition has a method called face locations, which basically returns the coordinates of the bounding box of each face in the image. So since we just have a single face in this image, I'm going to take the first value of the list that is returned by this method. So with these coordinates, I'm going to draw a bounding box using cv2.rectangle around the face. And next, I will also write this name in near the box. So to do that, I'll use cv2.putText. So inside this method, the important parameters are the image, the text that I want to write on top of this image, and the position where I want to place this text. Next, let's see the image. So for that, I'll use cv2.imshow. So in case you did not know, cv2.imshow is actually the method inside cv2 library to display an image, but it does not work properly on Google Colab. So what they've done is that they've written a patch for it, and you can use it with this import. Okay, now let's run this. We have our output. Yes, this is Elon Musk, this is Obama, and this is Bill Gates. I think I'll increase the text size, the scale of the text, and make it 1 so that it's a little bit more bigger. And you can see that after processing 2, it did not print any image because it did not match any result, right? So this condition was never true in case of 2. So it never entered this. So that's basically it. So this does not only work for images, this also works for video. Like I said, you can check out some more examples in here where they show how to do this in a video file as well. But I think this is a good starting point and gets you familiarized with all the methods inside the face recognition library that you'll be using. And also, I would always suggest using Google Colab for such projects, because instead of wasting time setting up libraries and setting up the environment on your computer, you can focus more on the code and more on the problem rather than wasting time in setup. It helps you get up and running fast. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful, and please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video, and I'll see you in the next one.